I like this. I tell you what, you working for Marvel, the Super Bowl commercial, did you get a lot of reaction to that Super Bowl commercial?
What Super Bowl commercial?
Oh, you know what? My mistake.
See, you're as crazy as the people on Twitter.
Right.
I'm not Laurence Fishburne.
That's my fault. Oh, I know that. That was my fault. My mistake. You know what?
We don't all look alike.
Father, you're
we
exactly
may be
right.
All black and famous,
you
but
are
we all
guilty.
Don't look alike.
I am guilty. I am guilty.
He thought you were Bob Dylan.
Right.
You're the entertainment reporter.
I know.
You're the entertainment reporter for this station.
Vlog.
And you don't know the difference between me and Laurence Fishburne?
My mistake. I apologize. Gosh. Really, my big mistake. Let's talk
that
about...
That must be a very short line for your job.
I'll say it. No. It probably would not be hard to get another person to sit right here. Let's talk about RoboCop.
Oh, hell no.
Really? Really?
I apologize.
I'm the other guy.
But
I'm the other guy. The other one. What's in your wallet?
Right.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's exactly
right.
There's more than one black guy doing a commercial.
There it is. No question about that.
I'm the what's in your wallet black guy.
Okay.
He's the car black guy.
There it is.
Morgan Freeman is the other credit card black guy. You only hear his voice, though, so you probably won't confuse him with Laurence Fishburne.
You're 100% right. To RoboCop,
there's a heavyweight black guy that's like putting cash down in the seats in a baseball stadium, but he's also the black guy that turns off the house, the water, and the lights when his kid tells him the house is cool.
Right.
I'm not that guy either.
Do we want to do a list of all the people that you're not?
And I've actually never done a McDonald's or a Kentucky Fried Chicken commercial.
Fair enough.
I know that's surprising.
Right. Fair enough.
Oh, man.
To the original...
And I'm the only black guy in RoboCop that's not a criminal.
Okay.
Other than Michael K. White.
Were you a fan of the Peter Weller version?
Yes. I love RoboCop. When it came out, it was like crazy innovative because it was making fun of the government. It was sarcastic. It was violent. Peter Verhoeven did a great job. I mean, there were even bare breasts in it. None in ours. I think they should have had some, but they didn't put any in it. But yeah, I was a huge fan of the original. And when I heard they were making a remake, I wondered why. And I read it. Still didn't know why. But when they told me Jose Padilla was going to direct it, I was really interested in doing it because I like his other films that he made in Brazil. And then Michael Keaton, Gary Oldman. How can you say no to that?
Well, I tell you what, it's obviously a great cast, and this director does have some extraordinary credits.
You know who they all are, though, right?
Yes, I do.
I mean, just in case they have some of them on the show. Do some work.
I won't make the
same. Do some research. Make sure you don't confuse them with those other white actors that are out there. Like,
this is a well-deserved spanking. Thank you for it. Let me ask you this. But the fact that you brought up that initial question, why are they doing this? A lot of people talk about that, these rebootings or reimaginings of franchises. So what convinced you was...
Well, they were successful films. They were successful films. People reboot some of those films because they think there's a new audience out here that hadn't seen them, or there has been a technological advancement that will allow them to do something that makes the film better or different in a certain way that will appeal to an audience that might want to see it.
Well, I tell you what, it is going to be...
I'm sorry for interrupting you. Go ahead.
Not at all. No, not at all. They're pushing us along, and I'm probably going to get spanked in the most extraordinary way with good reason. We should tell you Samuel L. Jackson's in RoboCop in theaters everywhere on Wednesday, February 12th. There we go. Thanks so much.
Thank you, Samuel. Come here. We'll give you one right now.
Right. That's
boom.
Right.
Boom. There we go.
Okay, let's go to the weather forecast.
Wow. You know what? That is a tape now that I believe is now going to have a life all of its own.
I think you're right.
We'll see on YouTube.
Yes, yeah. Sure. Very good.
Good morning, Harvey.
Yeah. Have a feeling.
In the weather forecast, things are going to be looking pretty good over the next couple of days. As the week goes along, skies will clear even more.